Hi, I'm Dr. Tiffany Chan. I'm an optometrist in the Low Vision Rehabilitation Division at the Wilmer Eye Institute Johns Hopkins Bayview Medical Center. So the term low vision refers to anyone who has chronic vision impairment that cannot be corrected with glasses, contact lenses, medication, or even surgery. So oftentimes, vision impairment can cause difficulty performing daily activities such as reading, seeing faces, watching television, or traveling independently. So my job as a vision rehabilitation specialist is to try to maximize the remaining vision of those patients with chronic vision impairment. I do that in a variety of different ways by using different tools or devices such as magnifiers, filters, contrast enhancement, or even using our other senses such as our sense of touch or hearing to supplement the vision changes. So I'm going to show you a few examples of devices that I work with. So this is an example of a traditional handheld magnifier. So with this one, similar to other magnifiers, it has a light here, and this can magnify the image and allow a person to read small print again. If someone has even more reduced vision or lower vision, they may need more magnification. So this is an example of an electronic magnifier. So there's a camera on one side, and when you put that on top of the reading material, that can enhance the magnification. And we have a variety of different settings to manipulate that print. So for example, by pressing the button here, I can increase the magnification. So if someone has to read very small print, they would use a higher amount of magnification. Or if they had large print or labels that they were looking at the grocery store, we would use less magnification. Another feature of this magnifier is contrast enhancement. So contrast, or the boldness of print, is very important for being able to read, especially if the print is very faint. So by pressing this button, we can enhance the contrast or make that print more bold and dark. And by pressing the button again, I can actually reverse the polarity of the contrast. So now the print is white with a black background rather than black print on a white background. And that can make all the difference when people are trying to read printed material. So as I discussed earlier, sometimes people have difficulty seeing things at a distance, such as faces or watching television. So this is an example of telescopic glasses. So you can see there's a double lens here, and that allows magnification when people are looking at things far away. So this type of device is worn similar to a traditional pair of glasses, and you can see how magnified that image is when they are looking at a distant object. And this can allow that person to see details or watch television. So another thing that we talked about earlier, sometimes people have difficulty doing things and we need to rely on other senses, such as our sense of touch or hearing. So this is an example of a clock. And if we press the button here,
the time is now 7 minutes to 10 a.m.
So instead of relying on the vision to be able to tell what time it is, we can use our auditory to hear what time it is. So there's a variety of different tools that we can use to supplement the vision in that way. So if you or a loved one have chronic vision impairment that is affecting your ability to perform daily activities, you should schedule an appointment with me at the Wilmer Eye Institute Johns Hopkins Bayview Medical Center in the ophthalmology department.